smell that.
What? What's wrong?
Something bad happened.
They're the ones you want. I am on your side.
You're on no sides. Drop the gun now.
You're making a mistake.
You pointed your weapon at a police officer.
Just
drop
listen
it.
Listen to what I'm telling you.
Five,
listen
four,
to
three,
what I am
two.
Okay.
Going to be okay now.
You sure about that?
It's tough to be a princess, but I like a challenge. How can you tell what love feels like when everybody loves you? Sometimes I feel like I've walked into someone else's dream. Everything is connected.
Hey, Warren, I got clothes. This is all I could find.
They stole it from downstairs, so.
Such a beautiful world.
Why are you in such a hurry?
Well, we got places to go, right?
Maybe we could just stay here and watch the TV. They got these shows in between shows that show you things you can buy in a store.
Commercials?
Yeah. It's terrific.
Okay.
It's like you wake up one morning and
commercials
suddenly your parents hate you and your brother's gay. And suddenly your parents hate you and your brother's gay. Everything is connected. If you can't be a princess...
I never had a surprise before. I only got two bullets left. I still hurt all over. Maybe.
Bart, two bullets? Seriously? And that's your excuse? I saw you kill someone by waving at them.
All that stuff you said to me about life and purpose and stuff. You think maybe surprises are good sometimes? Like, there can be such a thing as a surprise that helps you.
Yes. I do. Yeah. What doesn't kill you, you know, usually makes you...
makes you hurt real bad. It makes you cry.
Makes you stronger. It's... yeah.
I think you're right, Ken. I think I want to see where those two bullets go.
Okay. You know, I'll bet if you head out that door and start walking, you'll find out.
You saved me.
No, rub it in.
How are we gonna get out of this one, right? Just another crazy situation.
Farrah, the night you were kidnapped, it was me behind the door you were knocking on. I didn't let you in, and...
I know that. Obviously.
You knew?
It's not like I forgot which door I knocked on, Todd. It's my fault. I had have my weapon drawn.
Well, right, but...
When I met you that first night, you saved my life. By the time I realized that was your door, I knew you well enough to understand why that door did not open that night. It was my fault. I should never have been there in the first place.
Ah. See? You also knew a thing. I didn't lie to you any more than you lied to Farah.
Yes, you did.
I would describe it as strategic no-truthing.
Come on, go! 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 Stop! Stop! All right, calm down, Lydia. It's gonna be all right. We're gonna figure this out. It's gonna be all right. Maybe.
Corgi knows.
Yeah.
Or rather, Lydia Spring knows. I'm sorry, Miss Spring. It was destroyed after this nice, real detective shot it a bazillion times.
You shut up! Right? I need to focus. I gotta figure this out. All right? What is this place? Who are you people? How the hell did you do this to her? I want answers. Talk!
Okay, so, 100 years ago...
All right, I'm gonna need you to shut up with that shit right now.
I thought you said you wanted answers.
I want reality. I want my reality back, and I want it back right goddamn now!
I am not the enemy.
I just want to know what's going on. Please, will somebody tell me what's going on? Huh? Please.
More than 100 years ago, a man named Zachariah Webb built a machine that broke and went to the future where these tattooed wackos found it and used it to swap souls. They swapped Lydia with a corgi to use as leverage to stop Patrick Spring, who was actually also Zachariah Webb, having jumped through time to get his machine back.
I hate everything about this right now.
In 2002, after the men of the machine killed his wife, Patrick Spring, who was a fake identity created to be the son of Edgar Spring, who was actually Zachariah Webb, jumped forward in time to last week, destroyed the men of the machine, and then went to the Paramount Grand to confront his future self, which led to the young Patrick Spring accidentally killing old Patrick Spring when a kitten went off and set off a shark explosion.
Wait, so that's what happened?
Fairly straightforward, I think.
Estevez, there's still a way to save Lydia.
That's right. If you destroyed this machine and this plug, but there's another way.
Oh.
That
thing.
It's another version of the same machine, and we know where to plug it in.
Sir? Sir, you can't come in here like that.
Shut up, idiot. I'm talking to the captain.
Hey!
Boys.
Get in here.
Stand down.
You can't just come in.
They stole the soul exchanger.
And you know who has it? Your man, Estevez.
So, it's finally over. You got no friends left, Brimmer. I've been making calls to brothers in high places all day. Nobody's picking up. There's no one left to help you. Coming here, you put me in danger. The men of the machine are over. You've destroyed us.
No. They're gonna try and switch Lydia and Rapunzel back. We get the machine back, we get control. We are gonna go to the only altar that's left. We're gonna take men, we're gonna take weapons, and we're gonna go there. If we quit now, then we lose everything. But no. We go there.
Whoa. I got you. Thank you. I feel less walky and more fully
right now.
Don't mention it. You gonna stay with us?
What you mean, like with the living people?
Yeah.
Ideally, yes, but you know how things are when you got the cereal bowl flour exchange.
Say what?
There's a lot of wording happening. Should me no talk good, cause blood all gone.
Right.
Arrow have.
I see that.
Todd, you good?
The answer to that question has come along.
Let's go.
Come on, put you down.
There we go. There are 6 entrances to the house. There's no way we can cover all of them. So if anyone comes in...
Wait, would they come here?
This thing is like the most sacred thing. They're gonna be mad we took it.
So they know what's under this place. What is under this place?
A place with the... stuff.
Ah! Oh, shit. Miss Black. How much of this is legal?
There are a number of loopholes, you know, legally regarding what constitutes a militia with relevance to state law and in accordance
with... You know
what?
Never mind. This is the least illegal shit I've done all day. This is a time machine. Can I go back?
Go back? Where?
Save my partner.
Some things can't be changed. Lydia first. Oh,
are you sure you know what you're doing?
No. I only saw them do this once. We jumped them and they... switch places.
Make things switchy.
Switch. The men of the machine had a whole contraption for this.
Is it supposed to do that?
I'm not qualified to answer that question.
Why can't I go back? It's already on. I could go back. I could fix this. I could fix everything.
Bring Lydia here.
Why are we even bothering with this? I could go back and stop it from ever being kidnapped.
Because it doesn't work that way. Because it's...
Todd!
No, don't worry about me. We're too close to give up now. Hold her there. Okay, that's the best. Push that crank.
You freaking killed her.
Is this what's supposed to happen?
It's gonna work. Here. 3, 2, 1.
Lydia? Oh my God. Oh my God.
It worked.
Holy shit.
I thought it would never get you back. I'm so stupid. I should have never gone to that guy's house. I knew you could do it. The moment I saw you, I knew everything was gonna be all right.
That's right.
Thank you so much.
We did the best we could for you, Lydia.
These guys threw me off a bridge.
Help you. Come on. Look at me. We got company.
Wait, Farrah. Where are you going?
Stay here.
Farrah, wait.
Stay here.
Oh, Jesus.
We should destroy this stupid thing.
No, it won't work. It needs this. It needs to go back to where it came from to start the loop again.
They put me in a dog. I watched him feed me dog food. I've been sleeping on the streets for a week. I was so hungry, I ate a rat.
If we don't send the machine back in time, you won't exist.
You're the center of the loop. It all revolves around you. This has to go back to your dad so that he can try and manipulate the future and eventually meet your mom and sex with her.
Tut.
Everything's spinning.
Yep, still.
You guys are both dying.
No. No, we're not. We're okay.
Tut.
We have to get out of here. Someone has to tell Farrah we...
Your dad did all of this to save you. He died to save your life.
Okay. What do I do? On or whatever.
Turn the crank. Wait. No. Wait. The machine's still broken.
Shit.
You're right.
Fuck. Okay. Maybe if I could just...
Stop right now! I swear to God, I'll smash this stupid thing into a billion pieces!
You'll smash it. And then what? What then, Lydia Spring? What then? Who's that, Ed?
Yo.
What?
Sorry about earlier. I'll do it right this time.
No.
Bart.
This is it. These bald guys. These are the guys that hired me. The day you found me. And this thing. This is the thing that they hired me to build.
Can you fix this?
Yes. It's my destiny.
Drop your gun.
I am gonna shoot you in the head. I am gonna shoot you in the head and take my goddamn dog!
One of those things is gonna happen.
Bye, Dirk.
Let's get out of here. These people are nut jobs.
Amanda, you came back?
Me and the Rowdy Three came and saved you. They say that's the last time, by the way.
Save me?
Yeah, duh. Saved everyone. There were like 100 dudes out there, and we beat them up and then they ran away, dude. It was sick.
Where's Dirk?
The cop took him to the hospital. It was not pretty. Farrah took Lydia somewhere. She said to meet her at this address at 6. Dirk says you hate him now because he tricked you or something.
He ruined my life.
Right. All right. Later, Todd.
Wait.
What? You have another lottery ticket? What was your plan with that anyway?
I was gonna try and fix things. Fix everything.
Some things you don't fix, Todd. Sometimes when you fall down, you fall all the way down. You blew it. That's just the way it is. Here's what I do believe. I think Dirk Gently came into your life for a reason. I mean, 2 weeks ago, you were a 33-year-old hotel bellhop with no money and no friends who spent all of his time lying to me. Now look at you. You're the badass partner to a psychic detective. And you're honest. Think about why Dirk lied to you. You and Dirk, you saved that girl. You saved that girl's life. No matter what he lied about, isn't that the part that matters? I'll see you around, Todd.
Amanda, are you really gonna leave with those guys?
I mean, Todd, come on. They already gave me a jacket.
You hungry?
What is it?
Ethiopian.
That's not a word. Is that a word? You did a thing back there with the thing.
Yes, I did. You did too. Hey, that guy, Dirk Gently. You weren't supposed to kill him. You were supposed to protect him.
It's not the first time that's happened, is it?
I was supposed to bring you there too, so. And you did the thing, and now that you did it, maybe you're gonna leave. And... like, you did your destiny or whatever. And now that you did it, maybe you're gonna go. And it's bad, Ken. But you do whatever you want, you know, because I kidnapped you, and it must have been really bad for you. You know, I didn't think about your feelings and all that, and...
Security will meet you on the ground in Belize. You cannot call me when you land. From there, you'll be on your own. You can access your father's offshore accounts, everything.
I don't understand why I have to leave the country.
It's just for now. We don't know how many of them are still out there. They could still be looking for you. I don't even know who they are.
They're a cult formed around the time machine my father accidentally sent forward from the past. They use a broken aspect of the machine to swap bodies. The guy who kidnapped me was a rock star, and he got mad and betrayed them. Coincidentally, on the same day, my father traveled into the future to get revenge for the murder of my mother.
I'm so sorry things ended this way. I let you down. I let your father down.
What are you talking about? It was a time loop. There was nothing you could do. This was the best possible ending. Don't you see that? Farrah, you kicked everyone's ass and saved me. It was so... you.
It was.
Yeah. Ever since I was little, you were the most inspiring person ever. But you always try to hide from what a freak you are. And then when my dad died and I was a dog and everything was hopeless, there you are with an army of weirdos saving the day. It was perfect. You are perfect. I love you.
I love you too.
I just gave you $4 million.
Wow.
My phone. Duh. Have fun with your new friends. They seem insane.
In the beginning, it was just an idea. I wanted... I wanted so badly to believe that there was something bigger, a bigger pattern, bigger meaning. I knew when I first met you, I found it. It was real. It was all real, and you were proof. You are what you say you are, and I am so proud of you.
Very long story short, until yesterday, it hailed as my greatest case. One of deception, danger, double crosses, and an all-round perversion of high emotion, and, dare I say it, romance. Puffles the horse had faked, yes, faked his death.
I need the chair.
Sorry?
That you're in?
Oh, yes, quite.
God, you're here. But their case is over.
How's your shoulder?
Yeah, it's terrible, actually. Look, I don't understand. Did you want something from me, or I can't help you. I can't do anything to help your situation or what I said.
I don't need help. Here. I got this from your apartment.
Oh,
it's a Mexican funeral t-shirt. I don't have many left, so try not to get shot in it.
Look, I am sorry, but I don't understand. You're... What do you want? Why are you here?
I'm here because I'm your friend. Besides, I don't want to miss out on when the next case starts.
Didn't you say this band hated you?
Yeah, well... We're late. Farrah wants to meet up.
What? Really?
Once Estevez gives us the all clear, some people are going to ask us some questions.
Undoubtedly. And how do we answer them?
Well, yeah, we can't tell people about the time machine. We'll sound insane.
We don't want to sound insane.
No, we want to sound like sane guys.
So sane we're boring.
Yeah, two boring, sane guys having a normal time.
Let's say, best case scenario, we come out of this not arrested, despite all the deaths.
Yeah, the deaths.
What then?
I'd like to make an investment in your detective agency.
Really?
What? But of course. I accept your proposal as my venture capitalist. Proof of concept has clearly already been established. But I remain quite firm on the signage. A brass plaque. Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency. Name recognition and all that. I wouldn't want to muddy it with the jumble of Farrahs and Todds. It's cleaner this way. And how much can I expect me to say yes to?
If she's your partner, I don't think it's fair to nix her name.
No, I prefer my name to remain off the name.
So it's settled. And Todd, I feel like you're no longer an assistant.
I'm promoting you to ward. Isn't that like a male nanny?
Yeah,
I'm not. Okay, Dirk, you're pissing me off again.
Oh, but you don't like the
type.
Trying to cover up your tracks, ass.
Oh?
Why'd you shoot me?
Dang it. Pete's sakes. Now it's... No. Man, now it's... This is perfect. This is just so me.
I don't know why I shot you.
Are you okay?
No, sorry.
You don't know what's going on?
No, right, I know about the body-swapping guys and the machine. We just burned the spring house down and cleaned that up, and then we went and burned their place down, too, at the zoo. No, I've just been burning everything down. We had a big file on that. Big files on, like, everything. And what do I want me to do, read them all? I can't do that. It's boring. I just wanted to be in charge. But what they don't tell you is that once you're in charge, there's all this other, like, blah, 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 top secret, blah. You know what? They can't arrest me. Like, we're gonna go kill the rest of those body-swapping guys, and it's all, like, top secret, so it's off of books. And all I had to do was write, like, an email. and then we're gonna go get the psychics too. All the ones we've been tracking and more. And they wouldn't let Riggins do it, I guess, but they like me more, better, because they gave me $80 million. We have to kill everybody who knows about it.
Look, I guess I gotta kill you too.
No. No, you don't have to do that. You don't, I don't know anything. I don't even understand any of this. I'm just trying to be a good cop. I'm just trying to be a good cop. Please, you don't have to. Please, man.
Are you reaching for your gun right now?
I'm just doing my job.
So, if we do this...
We're already doing it.
Well, how do we find the case?
Just let yourself feel it.
Feel it?
Yes. Okay. Take a moment. Feel anything? Okay, close your eyes. Anything at all?
I... to go to the bathroom.
Hey, it's...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Farrah, would you excuse me for a moment? Just a moment.
Amanda?
John! Oh my God, they're coming! It's
what?
Really bad.
What's happening? Who's coming?
John, listen to me. You have to listen.
Wait. Stay where you are. I'll find you. You're gonna be fine. You're gonna be fine.
It began when I was
was 21 years old, and my mom and dad were begging me to go. So I left.